Hi. In this video, I'm going to take you step by step through the process of simplifying a radical when it's something other than just a square root. Here we have a cube root, specifically the cube root of 48, x to the 4th, y squared, z to the 8th. Since this is a cube root, to simplify parts, we want to see if we can rewrite each of these things using 3 as an exponent, because the cube root of something cubed cancels out, simplifies very nicely for us. So first off, let's take a look at 48. That number there, again, we need to break up to rewrite it as things raised to the third power. So let's see what numbers actually make up 48. What we want to do is take 48 and break it up into its prime factors. There are a lot of ways to do this, but in this example, I'm going to use a simple tree diagram. I want any two numbers that happen to multiply to 48. The first two I think of are 4 and 12. Since neither of these are prime numbers, I'm going to go ahead and break them up and see what multiplies to create them. 4 is 2 times 2. Those are both primes, so I get to stop. 12 is 3 times 4. 3 is a prime number, so there's nothing else to break up there, but 4, again, is 2 times 2. So each of these values that we have here are prime. These are the prime factors of 48. If we take them together, multiply them together, we get 48. So instead of writing it as 48, I'm going to write it as the product of all of these numbers. So let me switch my pen color again. This means instead of just 48, I'm going to end up having 2 cubed. Remember, we're trying to write this in powers of 3, and I happen to have 3 of them. 2 times 2 times 2 times one more 2, because you notice there were 4 of them here, times 3, the last factor I had. All of those multiply together to give me 48, and I specifically wanted to write it grouping things together into groups of 3, if possible. So right there, 2 cubed. Next up, we have the x's. X to the 4th, and I want to write this using 3 as an exponent, meaning sort of grouping them together into groups of 3. Since there are 4 x's being multiplied together, I can think of this as x cubed, 3 of them, times the one that's left over. All of those together make up my x to the 4th. Next up, y squared. Well, since there are only 2 of them, there's no way for me to use 3 as an exponent, so I have to just leave it as is. So I'm going to leave that y squared as is. Next up, we have z to the 8th. That's what I need to break up, grouping it together into sort of, if you will, clumps of 3. I've run out of room here, so I'm going to slide this over a little bit so I've got some more room to work with. So z to the 8th, putting it together into groups of 3. Since I have 8 of them, I can rewrite this as z cubed, that's going to use up 3 of them, times z cubed, which is another 3, so 6 total, that leaves me 2 left over, z squared. The idea is that here I have a total of 3 plus 3 plus 2, so 6 z's multiplied together. Sorry, that would be 8 z's multiplied together. 3 plus 3 plus 2 is 8, not 6. And that's going to make up the z to the 8th that I had in my original problem. So these are all, or this is all that I had under the original radical, so in the radicand, just broken up conveniently enough, putting everything together with an exponent of 3, if possible. So sort of breaking it up into its component parts. And this whole amount is what's inside my cube root. So I'm going to go put it underneath a giant cube root radical here. Now, each one of these parts that is raised to the third power, it's going to simplify. What I mean by that is, here switching pen color again, that the cube root of 2 cubed is 2. I can take that cube root. It's a perfect cube, so everything will work out nicely. The cube root of x cubed is x. Again, I can take that cube root nicely and have it work out perfectly. Cube root of z cubed is z. And again, the cube root of z cubed is z. So each one of these parts, since I can take the cube root of it very nicely, very perfectly, I'm going to go ahead and do that and pull those parts outside of the radical. That's going to give me, outside of my radical, 2, which is coming from this here, times x, which is the cube root of x cubed, times z, the cube root of z cubed, times z, again, the cube root of that z cubed. And that's everything that I can simplify out of the radical. What's left inside my radical, my cube root here, well, I have this 2, this 3, this x, this y squared, and this z squared right here. So let me put all of those inside. 2 times 3 times x times y squared times z squared. Basically everything I hadn't underlined in red up above. That's what's left inside the radical. Now it's just a matter of simplifying this and writing it using exponents or multiplying the numbers together. On the outside, I'm going to have 2x z squared times the cube root of 6x y squared z squared. This is what's referred to as simple radical form, meaning that I have simplified everything out of the radical that I possibly can, and I'm left in with the stuff inside the radical that I couldn't take a perfect cube of, so that I end up with this stuff here. Thank you very much.